क्वेश्चन करने पड़ेंगे.
How difficult was it for you to come back and start all over again because of the rain interruptions in terms of, you know, concentrating?
It's hard sometimes, you know, when you get settled, when you start scoring some runs and then suddenly the rain comes heavier and the balls, obviously, when the ball really start to get wet and when the condition gets really well for the batsman, you got obviously it's a bit unfair for the fielding side sometime, but when you have to come off when you're very well set and then go back in again and start to get you know first 15-20 balls you got to get in again, so I think it was a little hard, but sometimes it was hard for the bowlers as well when the ball was getting wet.
Was a long innings too.
Obviously, when I spoke to the players who played here before, and also you got to see what lines the bowlers are bowling, so what their strengths are. So I really concentrated quite hard which ball to play and which areas to score on. The good thing was my feet was moving and judging the ball really well. So I was very comfortable on the crease when I was standing on the stance. So I was really feeling confident about my decision making. So it really helped me go through to concentrate longer because I was very comfortable what I was doing. And when the ball came into my zone, I was always ready to score runs off it. So yeah, it was good pitch. It was testing sometimes when the techiness came about because of the rain. It did a little bit of the seam, and especially when the second new ball came, that period was a bit tough, but going through that, that was a good sign because it could really collapse. You can have a batting collapse right then because that's 8 to 10 hours were very crucial. So very happy that period gone quite safely for me and for the team also.
Did you realise you were only 3 runs short of Viv Richards' 208, which is the highest score by a non-Australian batsman at the ground?
I didn't know that, but obviously Viv Richards is a big name, so it would have been a great moment. I would have crossed, but I'm still really happy what I have achieved today. It's a really proud moment for me, for obviously for Pakistan nation also.
Yeah, and just so you've got now 3 tests, a triple century and 2 test double centuries, but just the situation and scoring it, you know, at the MCG, how big a moment is this in your career?
Yeah, it's a big moment. You know, this is it's always a historic game. You know, Boxing Day Test match has always been followed all over Australia and all over the world as well. So, especially when a subcontinent team comes to Australia, everyone expect especially as a subcontinent batsman, Pakistani batsman, really wanted to perform really well here, and that's really a happy moment that. Of our batsmen who scored runs here, Azhar Ali Double Centure is scoring runs. So as a batting unit, we are really happy, especially in the last 2 innings, the way we batted.
Is it the best innings of your test career?
It's hard to say, but certainly it's a big achievement, I would say, because as I said earlier, for me and for all of our teammates. So as a team, we really focus on this tour and really want to do well here.
Just I wanted to talk a little bit about the bowling. You know, Wahab's had a problem with no balls now, probably since he's been back in the side for the last couple of years. Is it something that the management and he don't really work on in nets or in training? I mean, it happens often with him. I think he's probably cost Pakistan maybe 4 wickets over the last year and a half with, you know, taking them off no balls. So just talk a little bit about whether how what kind of work they do with it.
Obviously, it's a lot of work has been done. Today obviously was not ideal, bowled a lot of no balls, but he works with the bowling coach, but today maybe he wanted to, you know, push really hard. I think he wanted to bowl really, really quick and try and get some reverse swing, because it was really good, so maybe that's why he was pushing too hard and the foot was going across the line too much. I know it wasn't ideal. But hopefully he can turn it around tomorrow, because he doesn't normally bowl that many no balls. But it's one of those days that it was really hard for him also, because he wanted to bowl quick as well, and the no ball problem really came and hit him badly.
My follow-up was on the kind of logic of using Yasir Shah with that line that he's bowling to wander in the left-handers initially, keeping it a three offside, six leg side field. I mean, it's not really working for Pakistan in this series so far.
Unfortunately, you know, today, again, he didn't get really much turn out of the pitch. That's why maybe he wanted to bowl straight. Whenever he went outside off, he got hit through the covers, I think almost every time. So it is hard to bowl outside off. He came round the wicket also, he tried that and didn't work. Then wanted to bowl straight, and today that really didn't work either. So obviously we'll think again tonight and come with a plan tomorrow which lines he's going to bowl. Sometimes it's really hard when it doesn't give you much chance to come outside off, because you can be easily hit through the covers.
Last thing, Azhar, sabse pehle to ye bata kiya ki is saal itni lambi innings khelne ka kya raaz raha hai aapke, maine 300 bhi kiya, 200 kiya, aur MCG mein jahan barish ki wajah se khasa problem hua, aana jana lag raha.
महल में कंसंट्रेट करना तो बहुत हार्ड था, लेकिन जब मैं ड्रेसिंग रूम में आता था तो कोशिश करता था गेम से अपना माइंड थोड़ा ऑफ कर लूँ और रिलैक्स रहूँ जितना, क्योंकि जितनी देर आप बाहर भी अगर सोचते रहें तो आपका एट द एंड जो है वो मेंटली तौर पर आप बहुत ज़्यादा थक जाते हैं. तो कोशिश ये की कि जब ग्राउंड से बाहर हों, जितने टाइम इंजॉय करूँ अपना टाइम ड्रेसिंग रूम में टीम मेट्स के साथ गप्पे लगाऊँ, अपने आप मेंटली ऑफ करूँ अपने आप को. जैसे ही 5-10 मिनट जब दोबारा अंदर जाने के लिए होते थे तो दोबारा फोकस होता था, और कोशिश की कि जो प्लान्स स्टार्ट से लिए उसी पे फोकस रहा, और कोशिश की कि जैसे ही मेरे एरिया में बॉल आया और उस पर मैं स्कोर करूँ, और जैसे जैसे इनिंग बढ़ती गई कॉन्फिडेंस और बेहतर होता गया. और आई थिंक बीच में टफ टाइम्स आए जिसमें थोड़ा गेंद हिलना शुरू हो गया था, लेकिन यह कि वो टाइम जो थे वो बड़े क्रूशियल थे टीम के लिए भी, मेरे लिए भी. वो था कि उस दौरान जो है वो अच्छा विकेट्स हमने लूज़ नहीं की, जिसकी वजह से आई थिंक लंबी इनिंग खेलने में फ़ायदा हुआ. MCG में डबल हंड्रेड करना महल हर प्लेयर की, स्पेशली जो ऑस्ट्रेलिया से बाहर से आते हैं उनके लिए तो उससे भी ज़्यादा प्राउड मोमेंट होती है, क्योंकि एक तो वो कंडीशन में खेल रहे होते हैं और इतना बड़ा ग्राउंड. ऑब्वियसली मैंने भी फर्स्ट टाइम जब देखा तो आई थिंक वन ऑफ द बेस्ट ग्राउंड इन द वर्ल्ड, इफ नॉट द बेस्ट. आई थिंक द फीलिंग एक लॉर्ड्स की फीलिंग आती है, और आई थिंक MCG की भी फीलिंग उससे कुछ कम नहीं है. आई थिंक बिट ऑफ बोथ, मेरे ख्याल थोड़ी कंडीशन भी बेहतर हो गई, क्योंकि काफ़ी ड्राई कंडीशन हो गई, जिसमें बॉल नया बॉल थोड़ा थोड़ा स्विंग किया, उसके बाद गेंद इतना स्विंग नहीं किया, रिवर्स स्विंग आहिस्ता आहिस्ता होना शुरू हुआ था, लेकिन उतनी देर तक डेविड वार्नर बहुत सेट हो चुका था। और आपको पता है जैसे जैसा प्लेयर जब खेल रहा हो तो रन्स कंट्रोल करना इतना आसान नहीं होता, लेकिन स्टिल मेरे ख्याल में हम थोड़ा सा डिसिप्लिन लैक किया हमने बॉलिंग में, लेकिन यह कि कंडीशन भी काफ़ी बेहतर हो चुकी थी और साथ में, लेकिन जिस तरह की हमारी बॉलिंग है हम उनसे एक्सपेक्ट करते हैं कि जैसी मर्जी कंडीशन हो वहाँ पे वो बेहतर फॉर्म करें, और इसी तरह जो है वो कल जिस तरह हम सबकी होप्स हैं कि कल आएंगे और थोड़ा रन रेट कंट्रोल करेंगे और थोड़ा प्रेशर बिल्ड करेंगे ऑस्ट्रेलिया के ऊपर, और जैसे ही 2 से 3 विकेट मिलेंगे तो होर सुनारी जो है वो गेम का चेंज हो सकता है।
थैंक यू वेरी मच।